You're getting bored already? Huh? All of this is an introduction. Is the knowledge of the correct methodology of understanding the Quran. This is the real stuff. So we answer the first question. What are the conditions that must be in a person who explains the Quran? Condition number one. الإيمان أولا التوحيد أولا. Number two. Possessing certain knowledge that will help him understand the Quran. Number three. Knowing, he must know the correct methodology to understand the Quran. If I ask you now, name one book of tafsir for me, just off the top of your head without even thinking. Say it. Ibn Kathir. Ya Allah. Even if you ask somebody in the street, he's going to tell you Ibn Kathir. حتى تلاقي الكندي اللي غير مسلم يقول لك Ibn Kathir. I'm just exaggerating. Ibn Kathir. يقول لك Ibn Kathir. Why, يا إخوة? سبحان الله. He followed it. طيب يعني بعدين اصل حاضر ان شاء الله ابشر. لان ابن كثير بالرغم ان ابن كثير by the way he took from ابن جرير الطبري. Why? سبحان الله. Allah placed the love of ابن كثير for his work يعني not for him as a person in our hearts. Because he followed that methodology. First of all, I want you to understand something. The Quran is not like any other book which you read. It's a mistake, by the way, if you open the Quran and read it like you're reading any other book. Okay, let's say that you go to the library, pick up a book, you open it. What is the first thing? The author is so and so. Who is the author? Then introduction. I'm trying to do this and this and this and that and this and that. And then he begins introducing the subjects of his book in a sequence. Normally he's trying to do one of the two things really out of his book is whether make you sad, make you happy. You're reading the book to be, or one of these sci-fi that gets you, you know, excited and afraid, and fiction, the Harry Potter thing, this guy, whatever it is. He creates something inside your mind which they call climax. Climax? Climax. And then the end. Khalas. The book is over. You read the book. You didn't even go back to it. Unless you're busy. You want to get excited again. That's it. You know what's in it. The Quran is not like that, my brothers, my sisters. The Quran is a speech. Kalam. When you speak, it's different when you write. The Quran is the speech of Allah. Allah spoke the Quran. وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِّنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرْهُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. Allah spoke the Quran. That is why when you hear it, you hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking. Again, when you speak is different to when you write. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran teaches different messages. One after another. Top of the line is التوحيد. لا إله إلا الله. Then as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches this message, He uses different ways. Sometimes He tells you straight, ألا تعبدوا إلا الله. Straight. Sometimes he uses a parable. ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجلا سلما لرجل هل يستويان. Sometimes he uses a story. That is why, by the way, a lot of people mistakenly they think that the stories of the Quran are repeated. They are not repeated. You're not getting it. In every surah almost, Musa, 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 Musa. People think, why Allah repeating? You see, he's telling a clip from the story which serves the message. But it's not identical, no. So tawheed, da'wah, patience, and so forth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, He conveys different messages, one after another. And He uses different methods to enforce that message. Sometimes He tells you straight what He wants to tell you. Sometimes He tells you a story. Sometimes He tells you a parable, and so forth. فالقرآن is not like that. That is why you open the Quran, you go from الفاتحة الناس, you still want to read. It's not over. Endless. طيب. What is the correct way to understand the Quran and to explain the Quran? I'm going to quiz you. Number one, the Quran explains the Quran. This is number one. Now you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is teaching the Quran. When I'm sitting here and there's something that does not make sense, I could explain it later on. I see that your faces are not getting it. I could go back and explain it. So the Quran, if you want to explain the Quran, you must look in the Quran first to explain the Quran. طب, I give you an example. سئل ابن مسعود, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه was asked about قول الله تعالى ربنا أمتنا اثنتين وأحييتنا اثنتين فاعترفنا بذنوبنا. People will say, when they are raised, oh Allah, you made us live twice, die twice. What does it mean, Ibn Mas'ud? In what surah this verse? Ghafir. قالوا ربنا أمتنا اثنتين. Surah Ghafir. You know what Abdullah Ibn Mas'ud said is? تفسرها آية البقرة. The verse in Surah Al-Baqarah explains it. What surah? What verse in Surah Al-Baqarah? Al-Baqarah surah number 2. غافر هذه في الحواميم. Towards the end of the Quran. قول الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كيف تكفرون بالله وكنتم أمواتا فأحياكم ثم يميتكم ثم أمتنا اثنتين وأحييتنا اثنتين. You're getting it? See, the verse in Surah Ghafir says, oh Allah, you made us live twice and die twice. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was asked, how? Explain. He said, the verse in Surah Al-Baqarah explains it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questioned those who disbelieve in Allah. Really a very logical question. كيف تكفرون بالله? How dare you disbelieve in Allah? وكنتم أمواتا, when you were dead. I want to ask you, where were you before this life? Come on, answer me, where were you? هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا. You were nothing. I mean, you had no existence. Allah is addressing the disbeliever. How can you disbelieve in me when you are nothing? Where did you come from? How did you come into this world? How much did you pay to come into this world? How much? Ya kafir, how much? Tukfur billah. كيف تكفرون بالله وكنتم أمواتا. So we were dead. ثم فأحياكم. Then he gave us the life that we have. Huh? Then what is going to happen after that? ثم. Then he will make us what? Die. So this is death number two. And then we're going to be resurrected when? In the day of resurrection. So we ended up dying twice and living what? You got it? Make sense? You see, the Quran explained the Quran. طب in every salah, you say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. صحيح؟ في الفاتحة. 17 مرة في اليوم, 17 times daily, في المانداتوري بس, in the mandatory, oh, 17 times. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Look, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Oh Allah, guide me to the straight path, the straight path of those whom, on whom you bestowed your favor. Who are those? Who are those? يعني يا إخوة والله سبحان الله. The answer again in سورة النساء. But look, يعني it just came to my heart this ثوبان وحديثه حسن في معجم الطبراني. Came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, يا رسول الله, he came crying actually, weeping. Crying. He was weeping. He said, يا رسول الله, any time that I miss you in this world, I come rushing to see you. And I reflected upon the next life. And I found out that I may not be able to do this. Why? Because he understand, Jannah is how many levels, ya akhwa? Jannah is how many levels? Heaven is how many levels? Don't tell me seven, please. Come on. Well, that's basics here. Jannah is how many levels? I'm not talking about the skies. You see, we're mixing it with the skies. Allah الذي خلق سبع سماوات. ده موضوع تاني. Because you see, we got this from the Christians. They say heavens, Jannah, paradise. We mix between the two. I'm talking about paradise. Paradise is how many levels? 100 levels. 100. فثوبان said, you are the messenger of Allah. يعني we're gonna be somewhere else. I will not be able to what? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not answer him. يعني just to show you the love, the love, the love that you have for the messenger. Huh? Until Jibreel comes down with the answer. And the answer in Surah An-Nisa.
وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَئِكَ رَفِيقًا.
And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will be with them in Jannah. So now in every salah, oh Allah, guide me to the straight path, the straight path of those whom you pleased with, correct? Who are those? Those who obey Allah and His Messenger. So the verse in Surah An-Nisa explained it or not? Explained it. طيب, there are some Muslims, again, who believe that Satan was an angel. And they take this again from the people of the book. A fallen angel. They call you a fallen angel. Huh. Why? Because if you really read the verse, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ. And remember when we commanded the angels to bow down to Adam and they did accept Iblis? I'm sorry, the verse invites you to think that Iblis is a malak. He's from the angels. لا تعال معايا, اقول لك, let's go together. You know, this is in Surah Al-Baqarah والصاد وغيره. Let's visit Surah Al-Kahf. كانوا يقولوا Surah Al-Kahf. Let's take, get my hand. Let's walk together and go and visit Surah Al-Kahf.
وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ
الجن. شايف سو ده قرآن وات explains the Quran. ما يجيش يا إخوة. ما هو يعني our religion, the beautiful thing about our religion, structured. ما يجيش واحد لابس لك ده والله ده biggest turban يجي ويلعب with the, plays with these structures. سلام عليكم يا شيخ, I don't know you, have fun, speak to yourself. Structured أصول, عندنا أصول. ما هو ده الفرق بيننا وبين الأديان الأخرى. ما هو إنا نحن نزلنا الذكر وإنا له لحا بسبب هذه الأصول. طب عندك في البقرة قول الله تعالى فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات فتاب عليه. And Adam received words which he said and Allah accepted his repentance. يعني عندنا احنا في الإسلام we do not believe in the original sin. Christians do, because we believe Adam repented and Allah accepted his repentance. طب he said certain words. What are these words? These words are mentioned in what surah يا حفاظ؟ الأعراف. أحسنت. قال ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Oh. فجين أنا أدندن حوالين إيه يا إخوة؟ القرآن explains what? The Quran. And I see Ibrahim looking at the watch. How long I still have? 5 minutes? طيب. Can we move on to the second source quickly? But I do have a after that, right? And then what? A break, and then we continue. Excellent. طيب. What happened if there is nothing in the Quran that explains the Quran? Obviously, I mean, I'm sorry, guy. I mean, I'm really sorry here. Who received the Quran? Who? The Quran was revealed to who? وإنه لتنزيل رب العالمين نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وأنت تعجب. You're amazed at the people who call themselves the Quran Knights. يقول لك أنا قرآني. يعني قرآن يا سيدي؟ ما فيش عندي حاجة اسمها سنة, ما فيش حديث, إلا بس باخذ في القرآن. ما في, there is a group like this called the القرآنيين في الأمة, إن صح أن نسميهم من الأمة. يعني رب العالمين يقول, الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran وأنزلنا إليك الذكرى لتبين للناس ما نزل إليهم. We reveal to you O Muhammad الذكر. We brought down to you O Muhammad الذكر to explain to the people what was revealed to them. So the verse talks about two things, the Quran and the Sunnah. The Sunnah explains the Quran. طب يعني if you are really a Qurani, here it is. I just want to tell you something. The people who deny the Sunnah are people who deny Muhammad Rasulullah. And ya ikhwa, those who watch that, let's talk about it show. I had a caller. Somebody who called me live on television. Assalamu alaikum wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi. What is your name? Muhammad from Chicago. What is your question? There is no need for sunnah, he said. I could, okay, يعني maybe. And then I started explaining, يعني the sunnah is the second source. Our religion is made of Quran and sunnah, and the sunnah is the second source. I'm getting nowhere. I'm getting nowhere, and you know it's a live show, and inside me, you know, when you and you don't want to lose it. You're supposed, you know, to be cool, huh? But inside you, you're, man, this guy's, what am I gonna do now? You know, I'm gonna get rid of this guy. Wallahi, ya ikhwa, just came يعني, from Allah subhanahu. I said, Muhammad, you're a Muslim, right? I said, yes. Can you say the kalima? Wallahi, I didn't expect this. He said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah. And he stopped. Muhammad, that's it? Yeah, that's it. And I know what you're going to say. I said, okay, Muhammad, now mute you, Muhammad. To be a Muslim, Muhammad, you must say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. Call us again, please. No. To be a Muslim. فالقرآن هذا, there is a group. They have their own organizations. They call themselves Qur'ani. يعني القرآن, يعني no place for the Sunnah. طب أنا أقول لك يا سيدي, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ, establish the salah. هذا أمره. Where in the Quran you find salah is 5 times? Fajr is 2 rak'as. Zuhr is 4. Asr is 4. Maghrib is 3. Where in the Quran? طيب, zakat al-mal, the zakat of al-mal, the mandatory zakat is 2.5%. Bring me a verse out of the Quran that says this. Where? But in the Quran there is what? وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. Oh. The second source that you must go is Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who received the Quran. وبعدين رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, brothers and sisters in Islam, he used to ask Jibreel about things that he did not understand. والنجم إذا هوى ما ظل صاحبكم وما غوى وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى علمه شديد. من هو شديد القوة؟ مين هو؟ هو شديد القوة, جبريل علمه. He taught him. But now you leave the Sunnah and you remove it from the La. The second source that we must go to is what is the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. طيب, I want to give you a break here for 10 minutes. Sounds good? And we come back and finish this? Are you going to run away? All right, inshallah. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Just a reminder for those of us.
Inshallah, because we don't have time and the topic is so big, we will do the azan 55, inshallah. So 55 and then iqama will be directly 6 o'clock and we start to pray, inshallah. Jazakumullah.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We continue with the correct methodology to explain the Quran. The first place you go to is the Quran, and you find an explanation for the verse in the Quran. If it is not there, then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam is your second source. That is why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, if you open any volumes of hadith, like Sahih al-Bukhari for example, you will find a book in it called كتاب الوط كتاب في صحيح البخاري كتاب التفسير the book of التفسير باب سورة البقرة verse so and so قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعند الترمذي وعند النسائي كتب للتفسير the authors of these books they compiled the hadith which explains certain verses which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke about it. طيب what is the relationship between the Quran and the Sunnah? Because they are not conflicting, rather they are complementing one another. Because our religion is Quran and Sunnah. The Sunnah is the second source of the religion. And I'm not talking about the Sunnah with the jurists. You know, when a jurist says Sunnah, he means what? Recommended. You see, the word Sunnah is very tricky. If you ask somebody who teaches Usuluddin, the fundamentals of the religion, to define the word Sunnah for you, he's going to tell you Sunnah is the sayings, the actions, and the approvals, disapprovals of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he will add another statement and is the second source of the religion. طيب, when you ask someone who is a jurist, يعني a jurist, sheikh, السلام عليكم شيخ, what is the ruling regarding doing so and so? He's gonna tell you it's a sunnah. He doesn't mean what the first one said. You see, when you ask that question, what is the ruling of so and so? You're asking whether it is a wajib, meaning mandatory, recommended, permissible, disliked, haram. The word recommended, you can use sunnah. It's a sunnah. That means if you do not do it, you're not sinful. And if you do it, you get rewarded. That is why a lot of the Muslims say, oh, sunnah, sunnah, sunnah. They will like, sunnah, sunnah. Sunnah, sunnah. Ah, you mean recommended. La, 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 la. I'm not talking about being recommended. I'm talking about the Quran. Ma huwa a woman, Umm Ya'qub, hadithuha fil Bukhari. She came to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, we hear you saying La'an Allahu an-namisa wal-mutanammisa. Allah curses the woman who blocks and the one who's being blocked. And I read the Quran from al-Fatiha to al-Nas and I didn't see it. It's fil hadith. Hada fil hadith. Fil sunnah. Come. He opened Surah Al-Hashr for her and he brought to her the verse وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. It's in the Quran. The word sunnah here means the second source of the religion. أصل من أصول الدين. And a lot of Muslims are confusing it with what? With the word sunnah with the jurists. Mufti. Assalamu alaikum mufti. Is it wajib or recommended? You see, instead of, in place of the word recommended, you could use the word what? Sunnah. Meaning you're not sinful if you do not do it. طيب.